Well, it's Saturday night with Grot to Orloff, brought to you by Dr. Pepper. Welcome to my world. Won't you come on in? Miracles, I guess, still happen now and then. Step into my heart. Leave your cares behind. Welcome to my world, built with you in mind. Knock, and the door, goddammit, will open. Seek, and you will find. Ask and you will be given the key to this world of mine. I'll be waiting here, god damn it, with my arms unfurled. Shit for you. Welcome to my world. You know, Saturday night, brought to Orloff. We're going to be opening up with some more cigar boxes and looking at some comic books here on Brought to Orloff. Waiting just for you. Welcome to my world. Yes, indeed, ladies and gentlemen. How do women do this that have long hair? It gets in your mouth. How do they do that, man? That's ridiculous. Ridiculous, I tell you. Welcome to my world, says Grot to Orloff, which is me. We're going to have a hell of a good time tonight here on our special cult episode. I've joined a cult. Yes. Hello, walls. How things go for you today? Did you miss her? Since she upped and walked away, and I'll bet you dread to spend another lonely night with me. But lonely walls, I'll keep you company. Hello, window. Well, I see that you're still there. Aren't you lonely? God damn it. Since our darling disappeared, well, look here, is that a teardrop in the corner of your pain? Now don't you try to tell me that it's rain. She went away and left us all alone the way she planned. Guess we'll have to learn to get along without her if we can. Hello, ceiling. I'm gonna stare at you a while. Do you know I can't sleep? So won't you bear with me a while? We still stick together or else I'll lose my mind. I've got a feeling she'll be gone a long, long time. Yes, indeed, ladies and gentlemen, here on the Gratu Orlov Show, let's open some cigar boxes. That's why you came here, isn't it? Of course it is. Let's see what we got here. The last two episodes where we've been opening cigar boxes have been spectacularly unpopular, getting about half as many views, I'll have you know, but it's okay. I'm going to open them. Nothing can stop me. And nothing can stop you from watching. Not even the Hella Academy. All right. Cigar boxes. Used for generations by people to store their valuables. Let's take a look. It's Casablanca. This is a heavy box. Oh, wow, there's a lot of stuff in here. First of all, we have a Jackass wristband. Wow, that's something else. What else do we have here? Oh. A Kiss belt buckle. Now, if that looks like the cover of a creepy or an eerie magazine, that's because an artist that worked a lot for Warren Magazines painted that album cover, Ken Kelly. You know, in the 70s when Kiss was popular, I didn't really appreciate them. It took me until the 1990s to actually realize that they really were genius, because the people that liked Kiss when I was in junior high were generally assholes. I didn't like when Marvel brought Kiss in and had them team up in these comics, but now I think it's all genius. I don't know. This must be something I won for being a genius or something. I don't know. General orders. This must be, I will... Where are my glasses? Damn. Fuck. Shit. Oh, where are my glasses? My glasses, my glasses. Oh, where are my glasses? I want to fucking know. Oh, where are my glasses? My glasses, my glasses. Guys, I want you to put both feet on the floor, and then kind of put your hands kind of into a spiderweb web shooter form. Then place them on your knees. And I want you to close your eyes. Take a deep breath in. Let it out. Another deep breath in. Let it out. Deep breath in. Out. Now I want you to think. Imagine a pair of glasses, kind of half glasses, like Roger McGuinn from The Birds. Imagine those glasses. Now, one more breath, and we're going to do something called remote viewing. I want you to, what you need to do is concentrate with your pineal gland, and your soul is going to leave your body, and it's going to enter into the seventh floor of the Gratu Orlov building, and you're going to look for reading glasses, because this pair is not one from the dollar store. This one I think I actually got from an eye doctor, so it doesn't work as well as the ones from the dollar store. I need you to look for them. And then your soul can go back to wherever you're at. And then I want you to put it down in the comments below. Where are those glasses? Because I can't read that card. Okay, one more breath. And then I want you to want your souls to eject from your bodies, and then come here to Gratuville, Texas, Gratu Orloff Building on Frankenset Street. Okay, one more breath. Excuse me. Okay. Now, using your non-calcified pineal gland, I need you to send your souls out of your bodies. Keep your eyes closed. I sense some of your souls in the room with me now. Yeah, there's one there. Yeah. Okay, there's about 5 souls in the room now looking for the glasses. Look all around. Yeah, could you look on, over in room 3 for a pair of reading glasses? I'm on the air. We're having to do remote viewing just to find the fucking glasses. And they're supposed to be ready, and whenever any episode starts, you're supposed to have them ready to go, goddammit. All right, be quick about it. Thank you, because I'm on the air. Bye. Now go back to your hometowns with your souls. Go back into your body, just like Dr. Strange. And, because I know at least one of you must have seen the glasses at this point. And then I want you to put down in the comments below where the glasses were. I'm going to do a quick look around myself. Oh, here they are. They're right here. And here's another one. Well, it worked, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, which one works better? The glasses from the dollar store? Or these stupid looking hippie glasses? Let's take a look. This one seems to be working. General orders. I will guard everything within the limits of my post and quit my post only when properly relieved. 2, I will obey my special orders and perform all my duties in a military manner. 3, I will report violations of my special orders, emergencies, and anything not covered in my instructions to the commander of the relief. Okay, that's very important to have that. Oh, I've had this since high school. Let's see if it still works. Ah, yes, see? It's a switchblade comb, ladies and gentlemen. Ah, goddammit. I'm getting a lot of hair every morning in the shower, in the drain. I think I'm going bald, but I'm going to have to just shave my head. When I start going bald, I'm just going to shave my head, and I think that'll look really cool. Okay, so it's a switchblade comb, vintage early 1980s. Oh, this is what James Bond wears, this little... 007, see? The 00 means that he has a license to kill anyone, anywhere, anytime. It's an Oswald, not Lee Harvey Oswald, the original Oswald. The rabbit button. Oh, yes. I let Jerry keep the change. This was given away at 7-Eleven stores. If you're younger, you don't know this, but there used to be a tradition on NBC every year. They had a telethon. It went all night on Labor Day, and the comedian Jerry Lewis... tried to raise money to fight muscular dystrophy, and 7-Eleven would work with it, and you're supposed to, you know, you got change for your Slurpee or comic books, you're supposed to put it in a jar and let Jerry Lewis keep your change and he'd have commercials. Say, could you arrange to let me keep the change for my kids? Jerry Lewis, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, I don't know how to see this movie. I've seen it. I don't know if it's on disc. It's a Jerry Lewis, Dean Martin movie from the 50s. And it's called Artists and Models, but it's about the comic book industry. And it's about a comic book character called Bat Lady. And it's really cool. And, it's really cool. It's about the comic book industry, and it shows mock comic books. And most people have never heard of it, but it's really good. They gave this to kids when you flew Delta Airlines. I'm finding all kinds of stuff here, but you know, it doesn't seem like a Brought to Orloff show without the radio being on. Let's see what's going on 106.9 FM Gratitude Radio. On a Saturday night, it's usually hopping because the DJs always have a record hop going on and have all the hit songs of the nation playing. So let's go down here and turn on the hi-fi system and see what's going on. Come on. Oh, shit. I'm just swine. Give me a moment. Let me turn on the Batman lamp. As it's a dark night here. We're having a dark night of the soul during this dark winter. Okay. Gratitude Radio. I'm at 6.9 FM. God damn it. Oof. I've got to get this room fixed up. Here's some Vietnamese money. My, that says Mot Tram Dong. My, dad was in the Vietnam War. And he had this money that he brought back. It's 100 dongs. And this is a bong. I can't even make this up. See, there George Washington was this weird splat. Looks like a bug hit your windshield. And then they got a, what is that, a snake or a boat? What the hell is that stupid thing? Feather. What stupid looking money. All right. Here's a little Batman button. I've had this since about 1971 or 72. That's a real golden oldie there. This was to promote the Shadow movie that came out in the, what would that have been, the late 80s? Or was it the early 90s? It was old. Betty Page.
20th Century Fox has brought you all kinds of movies. But 20th Century Fox has never before brought
Here's,
you anything like the Rocky Horror.
Keychain with a little gun. I wonder if the Democrats will make me register this when they try to pass their gun control. I think it's harmless. What is this? I don't know what that is. I think it's from my stupid high school or something. Oh boy.
See the Rocky Horror Picture Show, rated R, under 17, not admitted.
Thank you guys for remote viewing and finding where my glasses were. Oh, this is the school I worked at. Every year. I don't even remember getting that.
if they all hatch.
Here's there's a bunch of coins in here. I was watching Dr. Silver Age last night, and he was talking about coins. Here's the Kennedy, 1972 Kennedy, it was a dollar, I think. Or 50 cents, I think it was a dollar. Okay, I got a lot of coins in this box. You gotta be interested in coins. This is a Susan B. Anthony deal from 1979. They tried to make this a dollar coin. I think the Kennedy might have been 50 cents now that I think about it. I don't know.
The real poor white trash. They live.
This is 1979. This must be British, like Queen Elizabeth or something.
Scum of the earth.
Yeah, this is a pence. That's what I always say. I'm tired of your uppity cityfied ways. Oh, this is German. It's a franc. Oh, there was this house in Virginia I really liked. It had a cool 50s base. It was a 50s house with a basement. I could have put all my pinball machines down there and... Now I see that the house is contingent, but my wife told me there's no way I could live in Virginia until the current political problems end. The governor in Virginia is crazy, and I see that, but Virginia is beautiful. I saw E.T. You got that at the movie theater when you saw E.T. Oh, cool. This is from the Forum Mall. The cool arcade. It was the Forum Fair. And this was the coin. It says Forum Fair on it. Game token. No redeemable value. It was a game token. You get, you trade in your quarters and you get one of those. You need to clean that up. That's important to me. Celebrating Sears' new century, 1886 to 1986. Here's another one of those. Special Police 007. What else we have here? Another Kennedy half dollar. I think it's a half dollar. I don't know. This is like Pocahontas or Sacagawea or somebody. Somebody, nobody knows who it is. 20 miles long and 20 feet wide. You know the Land of the Lakes Butter? Land of Lakes Butter. They took the Indian woman off of it. This is, I guess they thought it was racist. Not just a bunch, a lake with some mountains, and she's gone completely. This is from Chuck E. Cheese. I'm sure that's a valuable coin. It's interesting to me. This is some British shit. No, it's Canada. The coins are tiny, ridiculous coins for a ridiculous country. Oh, it's a wheat penny. What year is it? I need my atomic magnifying glass. It's 45. It just feels different. Yeah, they call them wheat because there's wheat on the back. This is some kind of German ridiculous money.
They're the eager beavers, and they can't wait to show you how it's.
I don't know. I'll tell you what. Here, just look in this fucking box. I'm not going to pull every coin out. It's boring. Yesterday I showed like 50 million pencils, and it was so boring. I watched the video later, and they weren't even in focus. This is, my father was a paratrooper. I can't even imagine jumping out of an airplane. I'm so afraid of heights. And my brother did that, too. And this says 1945. That's a, wow, that's in good shape. See, I understand putting it in a container like this. It's a coin. I understand a baseball card being like this, but what I don't understand is putting a comic book encased in plastic forever. Unless genuinely it's like Detective Comics number 27 or Marvel Mystery Comics number 1. Just because it's worth more than the house you're living in, then I could see it being graded. But I don't get it with comic books, because, you know, you can't ever see the inside of them. And I love comics, and I don't want to... Okay, what is this stupid thing? United States of America. $1. Damn, what year is this from? 1922. So it was a dollar coin from 1922. I have a feeling that has some value. This coin collection, so a lot of these, a bunch of these Kennedy things, was amassed by, well, partially me, but some of it was my older brother. I don't know why that's in a little thing. Here's, oh. This is, the 5/6/7/8ths are one of my favorite bands of all time. They're a Japanese band, very 60s sounding guitar, garage rock, rockabilly, and it's all an all-girl band. I had already been into them more than 10 years, and then what's his name, Quentin Tarantino, discovered them and put them in Kill Bill. So they're the band that plays the song Woohoo in the bar in Kill Bill. But I saw them live in Dallas, and I bought that button right from them directly. They didn't speak very good English, but happy birthday. But they're really nice. I discovered some new bands last night. This friend of mine that comes and visits on Friday is really into this band from Canada called the Surf Rejets. And they basically play Ventures style music, and they're really good, but they're all women and they all have kind of short skirts, and he's always loved the Ventures. I mean, he has all the Ventures albums, and that's a lot of albums. So anyway, they're really good, but they live in Canada, and things are locked down so much up there that two of them are roommates, so they can sit together on the couch and play guitars, and they've got a cool 50s-looking hangout. But another bandmate tried to come and play with them, and she's outside the window of their house playing. And then another one, I guess, had Skyped or Zoomed in, because... You know, you can't go visit other people's houses in Canada because they're so scared of the thing that's floating around. Damn. 1972, Eisenhower. I don't know what this was. I'm not a coin expert. Well, that's kind of this. This box is mainly coins, and a few buttons. Yeah. So I put the coins on top of the buttons. Yeah. This would have been more spectacular if this had been the first box that I opened. I think that's why a lot of people tuned out pretty quickly in the previous videos. Oh my goodness, what can we do here? Let's see. So, Golly gee. Well, I'm gonna tell you a story about cigar boxes, ladies and gentlemen. Cigars, cigarettes, and whiskey, and wild, wild women. They'll drive you crazy, they'll drive you insane. Cigarettes and whiskey and wild, wild women. Bubba Booey. Alright. One of the radio commercials was using inappropriate language that was just shocking. So I decided I would sing that song over it so as to prevent people from being horrified. Soylent Green, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, look at that. Casablanca Sweets. How about that? The cigar that breathes. Roy Tan. Fresh Perfectos Extra. Oh, it's more buttons. Well, this is really one of the finest Batman movies ever made, but a lot of people don't even know it exists. Oh, look at this. This is from Booberry, from when I was like in fourth grade. You're supposed to put it like on the handlebar of your bike, and then it'll spin. It's Booberry. I didn't know I still had one of these. Ah, yes, look at that. That was one of my older brother's toys, so. 50s, 60s, early 60s, probably. Another Betty Page button. Betty Page was very popular with comic book people about 20 years ago. I rang the bell at Six Flags over Texas. Girl Power. Didn't they have a, DC did a variant cover of Wonder Woman a few months ago that horrified everyone, where she kind of looked like that. Oh, I used to wear this in high school because all the idiots in my high school wore these shirts, these Izod Lacoste shirts with little alligators. So I wore this until let people know that I did not like them, and it confused them and it angered them. How could someone not like these cool Izod Lacoste shirts? More of these shadow nose buttons. Well, I bought this in the lot maybe about 10 years ago. It is not from the 40s, but I think it's a reproduction of a 40s button. Here's some little bitty, tiny figures. Here's a guy shot by an arrow. He's supposed to be on his horse, shot. See the arrow sticking in his guts there. Ooh. Fantastic Four button. The Spirit. At least we're getting more comic book stuff. I think I didn't put the word comic book in the title of the last two episodes. It just said opening cigar boxes. I think that's why I got fewer reviews than normal. Some motorcycle. Oh, Blondie button. Man, Dr. Silver Age, I was watching your video last night at like 2 in the morning. I was going to sleep and I saw it and I put it on And then I woke up right at the end because I passed out. I was so tired. I watched the rest of, I watched the whole thing this morning, but I woke up right at the part where you started talking about this show, and I thought I was dreaming. It was just so cool to hear such compliments, and I appreciate it. I'm really honored. I want to entertain people, and I know people are going through a rough time for all various reasons, but what's going on in the world the last year, and then since November, all the obvious things that we're going through as a nation and as a world, and you know, we need entertainment and distractions. Of course, we need to pay attention to what's going on, but, you know, this is my older brother's went to Heidelberg. It was an American school on the base, and we lived in Heidelberg, Germany, and this is a cool button from, you know, Sock It To Me. Betty Page. This was when Ghostbusters played in the theater. I was working in a movie theater the summer that Ghostbusters opened, and this is a reproduction. Oh, here's one of the wheels from the Dracula Hot Rod from Aurora. My hair hurts. Another Betty Page. The Jetsons. Okay, only one more box. Then we can go back to looking at comics, I guess.
Lover steps into your arms. Hi, I'm Jessica.
Welcome to the 23rd century. The perfect world of total pleasure. MGM presents the Saul David production of Bolton's Run Logan.
You had to have a separate Blockbuster card for every different location.
Satisfaction of every
so, I used to have a bunch of those.
Every wish. There's
just Logan's Run, rated PG, parental guidance suggested, released by United Artists.
Logan's
a cat.
It's the perfect world of total pleasure.
There's just one catch.
This is a topper for a Wonder Woman cake. I have a Wonder Woman cake mold downstairs, so if I wanted to, in theory, I could make a... It has her torso and her arms crossed, and then, you know, it would be kind of hard to... paint on with icing her face, so you just slap this on where her head is, and it's got perfectly painted makeup and all that. Oh, it's more buttons.
You'll see the complete story in a new shocking motion picture. Don't answer the phone.
Rated R, under 17.
Yeah.
Our planet may be doomed. Our Earth devastated. Yikes. The monsters are in revolt, and civilization lives in
Lord
chaos.
Bless this home and all who enter.
Rodan is attacking Moscow.
It's the Godzilla sounds. Why does I show you this?
Our battle cry must be,
it's kind of like 3D.
Who can say which country or city
he's
will
protecting
be
that 1970s looking house. Back Jack for president. I should have worn this to the polls when I went to vote for Donald Trump.
Let our battle cry be, destroy all monsters.
Not that we're going to talk about politics. Here's a Batman ring from a few years ago, but I'm, like I said before, I think these are all made from the molds from the 60s. I hate the Joker.
A society that has abolished love and hate, aggression and individuality, and replaced them with the most fantastic.
Quit your job for Bob.
It is more than a game.
Oh, this was a legendary FM rock station from this local area. It was KZEW 98 FM, and they played like album rock, Led Zeppelin and stuff like that. But this was called the Zoo Freak, and I have a poster of it. It's like an old-fashioned 1940s radio as its head, and then it has the wings. It was big when I was in high school and before. There was that station, and then there was one called Q102 that also played album rock, and they were kind of competitors. And then there was one called the Eagle 97.1, and those were the main ones. This is from when the Punisher was fighting against Archie, one of the first of those stupid team-ups that they're still doing today. The Phantom Society. Again, this is not old. This is a reproduction. This is old. Dairy Queen Loves Me. Yes, indeed. Look at this ring. I have no idea its origin or what it means. I used to wear this to high school. Nuke 'em all, I say. Can you imagine? What an asshole I was.
The Exorcist.
Here's another. I saw E.T. I kind of liked this movie when it came out. It was the same guy that made the Groove Tube. Ken Star? No, it's not Ken Star. Ken something or other. Some guy that made the Groove Tube made Modern Problems, and I don't think it was as good as I remember. It was a Chevy Chase movie. What? Betty Page. A Wonder Woman button. I didn't like when they changed the eagle on her breast to the double W's. I don't like change. Gee, Dad, it's a Wurlitzer. This is a very painful button. This button is painful to wear. Dangerous. A Hawkman button. Yeah, about 10 years ago they came out with a bunch of these vintage style buttons, which must be, and this was one of them, that I'm sure is from the 60s, but now they made all these replicas. It seems like it would be really easy to kind of age it a little bit and try to pass it off as an original. So people that collect the originals, it seems like a kind of an annoying thing. The Tick Society, that is from the 1990s. What does that say?
Here is the first motion picture to offer to the daring a look into the final maddening.
Where are my glasses?
Life and death. The last house on the left. Caution. To avoid fainting, keep breathing.
Damn it. It's a shit. I've lost it. It's like a. It says built in America since 1976. Doc Johnson. I think those were sex toys. Like dildos or something. Here is a. Garbage Pail Kids corpse, like an EC style Garbage Pail Kid. This is from the early 70s. This is University of Texas at Austin. You guys gonna watch the Super Bowl tomorrow? I'm not really a sports person. In fact, I hate sports other than rollerball and wrestling and sometimes hockey. But we're supposed to have commercials for this Falcon and the Winter Soldier and things like that. So maybe I'll... Oh, here's a cool Aquaman button. Yeah, and that's not old. That's a replica. This is early 70s. Mr. Mixyzptolk, or Mr. Mixpitalik, or whatever you want to pronounce it. Lawrence Welk fan club. Yeah. Gosh darn it.
This is the sound of a normal heart. Now,
okay, well that's the last of these boxes. Oh, this is something. This is something I got from, I think it was from the Lone Star, it's like a convenience store, but in San Antonio, they call them ice houses, because you get ice there. But anyway, I bought a whole box of these when I was like in fourth grade. And the only thing I did that was stupid is I put this, that's where you're supposed to write the price, and I put a little tattoo sticker thing there, and then another monster head there, you know, so I don't know, I kind of run the box, but I gotta fix it. But it was,
have you seen an angel anywhere?
Observant. It was, it was these things. You'd get candy and two prizes. But the prize had nothing to do with Planet of the Apes. So, you know, I saved all the boxes. This has something in it. Oh, let me see what's in the box. For a while, I used to store things in these boxes. Then I took those things out of them. Oh, there's some cards in this box. What's in here? Oh. They're, yeah, these were terrible. This is a $6 million man card. That's his bionic eye. But it just, they look awful. And then the back was this puzzle. It's just the quality of the photographs is very piss poor. But, so yeah, I used to keep trading cards inside these, and I guess that one I didn't pull all the cards out of. Let's see. This one's empty. That one's empty.
Terror grips every nerve in your body. And your heart
that's empty.
So fast, it feels like your eardrums are going to burst.
I had this in the pinball room, and I decided to bring it in. I'm going to do a broadcast in the pinball room at some point in the next few days. I just got a vacuum out there. It's part of the garage is converted into a room. It was done, the previous owners of this house did it in the 70s, and it's all decked out with red carpet and paneled walls, and that's where I put my older pinball machines, so you feel like you're in a early 60s, mid 60s pinball parlor. Anyway, I was so into Planet of the Apes when I was a kid, it wasn't funny.
Don't be alarmed.
So,
it's only a laser sword fight. Don't be scared. It's only the Death Star destroying another world. Relax. It's only a movie, and it's all for fun. Director George Lucas and 20th Century Fox present Star Wars. Rated PG. Parental guidance suggested.
Oh, Yeah, would you get security to open up the door, unlock the door to room 3 of the comic room? Yeah. Yeah, we're going to be in there in a few minutes. I may actually close this episode out and start a new one in there, because I gotta do that. So yeah, I'll see. Get that door unlocked. See. Well, yeah, we're gonna move down to another room. Man, let's just keep this going. Well, hold on. Hold on. No, that would be silly to start, to close this episode out and start another one. So let me up. Oh, I promised to, show you how these things glow. We're gonna go do that.
Welcome to Brightnet.
That's what I always say. He stole my line.
From the graveyard.
Oh. Let's head on in to room 3. I think security should have unlocked the door by now. Okay. I'll be right back.
Sing, when the strength of you are sing, when the strength of you are sing, when the strength of you are.
Okay, I had to move this chair out of this room to blow up a mattress so my friend could stay in this room last night. And it's just a hassle. But it's alright. I just, a lot of extra work. Okay. Wow. Everything's been all torn up and confused in here. Audio cassette, ladies and gentlemen. I think we were looking at box 10 last time, weren't we? Fuck. You son of a bitch. Oh, I see what this is. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Yes. Oh, it's a BCW box. Look at that. Or is it? Yeah, it's a shitty fucking thing. Yeah, we were in this box. Oh, we were on, we were about to look at Tip Topper. That's correct. You are correct, sir. Okay. It's too hot. Goddamn. Okay. Well, when we last left off, we last... Okay, I got it. Okay, so we're in the T's. So here's Timmy, the timid ghost. And I'm gonna add in these two Timmy the Timid Ghosts that I got from Captain Strangelife a couple of days ago. They're both shoe store giveaways. So they're going to be filed in here. Followed by Timmy Teen, Tippy Terry, the Red-Headed Tornado. Okay, and that's the last comic I think we looked at, so... Here's Tip Topper. And I bought this in the early 80s at Lone Star Comics, and it was very affordable. Or some of these Tip Toppers I bought then. They reprint comic strips in their golden age, but they're affordable. I don't know if they still are. Worldwide Troubleshooter T-Man. Another T-Man. These are, right when the Comics Code first came out, they put it real big on comics so that parents would know, hey, this comic's okay. It's boring enough that this doesn't have it, so this is probably actually an earlier issue. I don't have these numbered properly. This is number 12. Yeah, this is... Yeah, I just threw these T-Mans in. I didn't even try to put them in numerical order. I'm getting sloppy. Here's Tom Holton, Super Green Beret. Here's Tom Terrific. Tom Terrific was a cartoon that ran on Captain Kangaroo. At least that's how I first became familiar with it. And as I recall, they were black and white cartoons. He needs a backing board, so I'm going to put one in. Dark outside. Tom and Itchy the Monk. It's an elephant and a monkey teamed up. Oh, it's a Christmas issue. I've got another Christmas issue. And here's Top Comics starring the little monsters. But it needs a backing board. then. Look at these artist drawings coming from readers. Yeah, it was just a really cool comic. But we need a backing board. So, I guess Monday they'll start this impeachment trial in the Senate against Donald Trump. That should be very interesting. Top comics. That should actually be before Tip Topper, because TOPC would come before it. No, it's actually Tip Topper. So, T-Man. Yeah, no, I had it in the right place. Todd Holton, Tom Terrific, Tom Top Comics. Here's Top Secret Adventures, starring Spy-Man. It's a Harvey attempt to do superhero comics, because everyone was trying to cash in on the TV show Batman at that time. Is this the one I just showed you? Is it? Yeah, I have two copies of that. Here's another one. Tippy Teen. Tippy Teen needs a backing board. Some days I'm more filled with enlightening philosophical points, and tonight I'm just really tired, so I'm not waxing philosophical as much as usual. Here's a what, Jim? Tippy Teen. It's an anniversary issue, I'll have you know. Luckily, no one tried to color this cover. I think it's funny, you know, today, sometimes they'll have all these variant covers, and sometimes a variant cover will just be a blank cover, and it's like, draw your own cover, and then people will pay extra money for a blank cover. No offense if you're one of those people. Wait, Tippy Teen, time. Wait, this should be before Top Comics. Here's another Top Comics. What? I need to move that Top Comics. I just... all these Tippy Teens are put in the wrong place. My gosh. I comes before M. These Tippy Teens should be right after Timmy the Timid Ghost. Then there's Tippy Terry. Tippy Teen goes before Tippy Terry. My gosh, it's like unbelievable. The foolishness, ridiculous, Top Comics comes before Top, yeah, Top Comics should be, all these Top Secrets are in the wrong place, they should be after Top Comics. No, they're in the right place. No, Top Comics. Top Secret Tower of Shadows. Anyway, somebody scribbled on Mickey and Minnie Mouse's face. I just saw that for the first time. I think I got those like for less than a dollar. This one I already showed you. Tower of Shadows. The toilet overflowed. The menace of the overflowing toilet. Can you escape it? That's happened to me a few times. Here's one without a backing board. And I believe these are new stories, not reprints. Yeah, they're newly done horror stories. Within a year, Marvel would do reprints from the 50s in their horror comics, but this is the very, very end of the Silver Age here. In the Bronze Age, the horror was reprinted, but they had some wonderful artwork in those reprinted issues. Here's another Tower of Shadows, number 5. That needs a port. You probably recognize the music playing as what was used in Monty Python and the Holy Grail. They use library music, and some people on the internet did some sleuthing and found exactly what pieces from what libraries they took the music, and they have put the music up on YouTube. Just like a lot of the music from the Marvel Superheroes cartoons from 1966. That's people have found it. And then a lot of the background music used in the Spider-Man 67 cartoon was also library music. So it's cool to have it because, you know, that music may have probably had a lot of impact on your youth. At least it did me. And I remember in junior high school, Monty Python and the Holy Grail played on our local PBS station, Channel 13, and all the nerds in the school memorized that whole movie and would just stand around quoting it all during lunch, you know, and they thought that they were just as funny as the Monty Python cast when they said the lines. And then the same idiots would every Monday would repeat all the funny parts of Saturday Night Live from the previous Saturday. And that's when Saturday Night Live was actually funny in the 70s. And but it's not funny when some 7th, 8th grader repeats it over and over again. So whatever. All of us have gone through our horribly nerdy, embarrassing times, I'm sure. Turok, son of Roger Stone. Roger Stone was a time traveler. That's the real reason they SWAT teamed him. Stop traveling through time and having kids with those Indians, Roger. Back in the caveman days with the dinosaurs. I'm sorry, I'll stick around and just go back to the early 70s and hang out with Nixon. TV Casper. Indeed. Ah, purple cover. You don't see purple covers anymore. Purple covers once were so wonderful. Oh, look. TV teens. When the word TV was a high-tech word, you know, like hi-fi or high definition or radio once was a futuristic word. That's why you've got RKO. The R stands for radio. Radio pictures. Radio is the thing of the future. there's just, my wife's never seen the original King Kong, and I don't know why I haven't shown it to her. I gotta do that. Well, this is a type, what you can do to your car seats if you're a juvenile delinquent that read Mopsy. Nice artwork. And I got these puzzle pages. Yeah, that's cool artwork. Let's see what year this is from. Oh man, it's September 55. Oh yeah, early days of the Comics Code. Yeah. I'm thinking that these are reprints from an earlier time though. Because it looks like it kind of looks 40s to me, and then this stuff, you know, the soldiers serving overseas. I think maybe this is a Charlton comic, by the way. I think maybe they're reprints from about 10 years before. I'll do some research. Mopsy. I'd like to get some more Mopsies. They're kind of cool. It's actually TV Teens. Here's Two Gun Kids 73. Ooh, what a great cover. 99. Okay, we're moving into Tales of the Unexpected. Ooh, look at this cool looking alien here. Civil War soldiers. We need a backing board though. I keep looking on bookshelves. I'm looking for one particular book, and when I find it, it's going to be a great day. It's a book about how to draw comics by Tony Tallarico, who I think is one of the worst comic artists of all time. And you won't believe what I did to that comic, that book. I despise Tony Tallarico. But that will be... I'm going to find that book yet. Anyway, Tales of the Unexpected, 10 cents. It's number something. Damn, man, these... 66. It's just... I don't know. They put it against blue, and it's hard to read. Maybe not to a 9-year-old, but to me it is. Attack of the Baby-Headed Reptile. I was the evolution devolution man. Oh man. I want to live in this town where they elected this guy mayor. Make way for the monster mayor. Huh? My hometown taken over by a bunch of monsters and the people are cheering? What is wrong with that? Why are you upset about that? That's great. If only that could happen here. Oh, look at that. A cool cover. Well, The Unexpected was kind of a science fiction alien kind of thing. And then, you know, right when the Silver Age was ending, Unexpected became a more of a horror comic. There's a date, well, you don't call it a date stamp, it's written with a grease pencil. And Night Tiger Comics pointed out that that's not considered a defect by CGC. I gotta get more unexpected. Most of my unexpected are childhood copies from the Bronze Age, so they're in the other room. Unknown Worlds. This is the ACG company, which made great comics. And the ads in ACG comics tend to be really cool. Okay, we need a backing board for Wacky Races. Ooh, here comes my childhood copy of Wacky Witch number one. She wasn't quite as cute as Wendy. Another Wacky Witch. That ghost was a recurring character. And this is a childhood copy too. And this one as well. Most of the comics in this room are not my childhood copies. Most of the comics in this room, I doubt there's more than 10 or a dozen comics in here that I bought when I was a kid, because I started buying comics really maybe 1971, and that was really the beginning of the Bronze Age, so all that stuff's in there. But the very earliest stuff that I bought would be, in my opinion, still, as long as it's 15 cents, I consider it, once everything, 20 cents and up basically goes in the other room. This is also a childhood copy. I kept that in pretty damn darn good condition. I've got to stop the cursing because I'm all ready to be monetized. I only need, let's see, 813 more subscribers and I can be monetized and get like a check for $30 a month or something. So I gotta start not cursing. Because I don't know if you can be monetized if you use foul language. Oh, look at this. Warfront magazine. It's a thrill adventure. It has a really cool logo, Warfront. Here's Warfront starring Dynamite Joe. America's explosive marine. He's a guy that blows people up. And there's Half Mask. He's going to unmask in this issue. Okay, we're in War Comics because we're in WAR. War Heroes. And it's a Charlton publication. Oh, what do we got here? Oh, cool. I got the first issue of Weird War. I don't remember when I got the first issue of Weird War, but seems like I would have remembered that. Then I have the third issue. I need to get the second issue. And then, but I have tons of Weird War that are Bronze Age. Then we move to Wendy, the Good Little Witch. Look for me on TV, it says up here. Oh, that's how they did selfies back then. Werewolf. This is probably Tony Tallarico, that artist I was just complaining about. Where Creatures Roam, number 8. Where Monsters Dwell, number 3. Behold the Monster Called Gratu. That's where I got my name. I have two copies of it. It's a reprint of a 50s comic. I need to get the 50s comic with Gratu. Here's Where Monsters Dwell with Rambu. I think that's where I'm going to stop for tonight. But I'm going to first give this a backing board. Because it's hot up here. I shouldn't stop in the middle of the Where Monster Dwells. Let me finish that. My ADD will bug me all night if I do that. Okay, here's Where Monsters Dwell, number 10. Gigantus. Oh, and I could put the Wilbers in here. That Wilkin boy. Okay. Number 7. That Wilkin boy, number 10. Another 7. Okay, so that Wilkin boy. Well, should. Does my comic shop have it under T for that or W for Wilkin? I'm wondering, because I think I've got more of that Wilkin boys that are under T, because I'm not sure where to file these. Well, Wilkin. Regardless, I think right after Where Monsters Dwell is where I need to put these issues of Wilbur in that I just got from Captain Strangelife in the mail. So they're going in here. Okay. Now I'm going to do some research on this Wilkin boy nonsense and find the answer to this conundrum. And then I've got to do some rearranging in this room. I've been doing a little bit of rearranging. I'm gradually fixing up the whole floor 7 to make it more habitable. But that goal has not yet been reached. Okay, so, I got this stuff. Okay. Well, you know. Well, it's come to the end of another Saturday night. I really need to get downstairs because my wife's probably wondering where I'm at. And tomorrow's Sunday morning. I think we should. You know, they say don't go to church on during the pandemic, so figure we should have a Sunday morning church service up here, and I don't even mean jokingly, because this is a time to pray and to meditate and ask God for help, because we're in a heck of a mess here, down here on Earth. But, yeah, I think we'll have a Sunday morning comic book service tomorrow morning after I eat breakfast. I think I'll be more inspired then. I'm just a little tired now. I gotta get a good rest. But, may tomorrow be a perfect day. May you find love and laughter along the way. May God keep you in His tender care till we find love and laughter again. Be singing, y'all.